second one, and as you see, the topic is not is enough clear and good. So let's invite our professor here.
And we are ready.
Okay, thank you very much. I feel honored to be here in this beautiful city. This is our third time here. We are working and having do some work with Marvin. So you see here that we're talking about sleep deprivation. Sleep deprivation is one of the important problems in any kind of military world. They have very less to sleep, and sleep deprivation is not a small problem, because if you are awake due to your profession, even medical doctors who are in emergency and they have the same problem, then you have problems in intelligence, decision making, and many other things. I will come later. So we are working on together with US Air Force, Wright-Patterson Air Force Base, because they have a problem, sleep deprivation. And this is a big problem in military, and we try to reduce their consequences, the leadership and decision-making failure. So this is very important, and we are trying with nano delivery, and this is a compound manufactured from Austria. It is not a single drug, it is a combination of many different kinds of drugs. I will come to later. And this is sleep hormone, alpha melanocyte stimulating hormone. And of course, this is Aruna Sharma's main work. It's my wife, she's sitting here. Dr. Murasano is from University of Medicine and Pharmacy from Romania. Dr. Lafuente is from Spain, Bilbao, Spain. And Dr. Asia Oshkisi, she is from University of Arkansas, Adrian. Dr. Ryan Tian is also there. Dr. Nojari is from Harvard University, Boston. Igor Manjuru, I just started working with, and he's from this university and also Far Eastern Russian Academy of Sciences. He's a very nice guy. Dr. Patnaik, she is from Banaras Hindu University in India. Dr. Mosler is from Austrian company that can produce this drug. And this is my myself, Dr. Sharma. We have collaboration with the Department of Defense, United States Government, European Office of Aerospace Research Development, and US Air Force Human Health Factor, mostly from Moderna, and Swedish Government. And I'm from Uppsala University, from the hospital that is more than 350 years old. So, I guess you understand English quite well. Now, before I tell you anything, I must say that whatever I'm telling you, there are conclusions, opinions, these are mine. That's nothing to do with any government or any other government. As you can see, that sleep deprivation is a very common problem in military personnel. 12 hours of sleep deprivation reduces brain pathology. And military personnel are also exposed to brain damage. So the point is, if they are sleep deprived, combat operation, and they have additional head injury, the problem is much more worse than what can imagine. So we feel that additional traumatic brain injury could further exacerbate traumatic induced brain injury. And we can see that several lines of evidence suggest that traumatic brain injury, there is a decrease in alpha melanocyte stimulating hormone, and also in neurotrophic factors. Do you know what is neurotrophic factors?
Yes.
In our brain, there are several kinds of neurotrophic factors. One is brain-derived neurotrophic factors, but some neurons. Then glial cell-derived neurotrophic factors that affects glial. And when there is a decrease in these neurotrophic factors, I mean your intelligence and neuron plasticity, both will be affected. So we try to understand that this could be one of the leading causes of brain pathology in sleep deprivation. I just put this cartoon here that sleep deprivation, how can affect your health? Symptoms of depression, impaired cognition, higher levels of anxiety, stroke risk, increased risk for diabetes, increased risk for heart disease, and even weight gain. This is quite similar for both men and women. In military, you can see sleep deprivation in military is quite prevalent. Partial sleep deprivation, insufficient sleep for several days of weeks, total sleep deprivation during awake, being awake for 24 hours continuously, sleep debt, cumulative effects of insufficient sleep. And this is the problems that we are working on that. I can show you this very interesting graph, and this was published in July 1997. You see, the mean relative performance, you see here, hours of wakefulness, and here is the blood alcohol concentration. It's very interesting. Sleep deprivation can induce your mental cognition of deficit very similar to the level of alcohol. And 24 or 26 hours of wakefulness also increases your performance. So this is quite interesting. Well, as I can tell you, sleep deprivation, they have different points in the brain, sensory input. They are coming from prefrontal cortex, septum, hypothalamus. All are attenuated or disrupted. Elevates the suggestion of gains and attenuates response to losses following this incident. This was published in 2007. Then about sleep deprivation and alpha-melanocyte-stimulating hormone. As you can see that there are different cases. Non-obese and obese, there is slight decrease in alpha-MSH over different medications. Non-obese and obese is also different. And the point is that why we are using alpha-melanocyte-stimulating hormone in our human body or any in vivo things, if something is going wrong, then something has been used. So alpha-MSH is also one of them. It protects endothelial cell function. Cultured brain endothelial cells from sarcopenia induced damage to the alpha-melanocyte-stimulating hormone. These are the side effects. Then I was quoting something from alpha MSH is increasing by one of patients for 10 days. It is the cases. Therefore, if we administer exogenous alpha MSH, maybe. Here you can see that there may be association between brain and the diagnostic factor and the important function condition and depressive symptoms for the severe. This is the median of the CSF. You can see the injury. This is the trend of injuries. And also median of the CSF. So this prevents the ability for the effect. Therefore, we try to understand the acuteness of the lung of biomed and the median can reduce some of the symptoms of sleep regression and trauma. We have animal model of sleep deprivation and this is an inverted flower pot. We have filled then with water and inverted flower pot. The water level is that's the place of water flower pot. So then we can sleep, but they will not have rapid eye movements. Because when they are sleeping, they can tell something and they are. This was the model. And then after different hours of sleep deprivation, they reduce brain. So this is the model you can see here. This is their fall. And if it gets to sleep, then it can tell how much water. So REM sleep is also that the latter fell into deep water only. Lying back, the environment for drowning. So it is interrupted. And the public is this was the model of brain injury I showed you yesterday. This weight is dropped for 20 cm and it uses 20 cm. This is moderate concussive injury. Fracture is not there. There is no injury. when you power. So if you control on the right side, the left side will control. This is called control. This is very established. On this generation of alpha nanoscience, we are centralizing. Number of submitted discrimination in the design. This one for consideration of the innovation. And you can read, it is placed on top 15% of all submitted technology to this top technological award by the discoverer. And help us with the citation, see the core system in the MMR, qualify a message, and centralizing and system and these government organizations that we should. So we understand that probably we are working in the right direction with the right tools. So in this case, I show you some result, 48 hours of sleep deprivation and 24 hours after sleep deprivation, images of neuronal glial and axial damage were examined. Plasma MSH that also show significant reduction here. Reduction in the DNA was also here. Then we have added the experiment in these things. So what you can see, that sleep deprivation reduced cardiac physiology of brain damage following accidental injury and their modification in the body. So these are the parameters that we have linked to the barrier, then edema, plasma, alpha, MSH, and plasma. These are the controls. You can see that after sleep deprivation of 48 hours, all values you can see have increased. And BDNF alpha and MSH. When we have combined with 24 hours after CHR, we have further enhancement of blood-brain barrier number down, edema formation, and the level of alpha MSH and bleeding is subsequently increased. Then we have given alpha MSH by general neuropsych MRI delivery, and then this is a glycine plus alpha MSH by general neuropsych MRI. But you can see that the values, alpha MSH was alone able to reduce from these sleep deprivation percentage level in all the things and slightly enhance the alpha MSH and bleeding level. But if you have a combination here, you can see that bleeding level was significantly increased, also the alpha MSH much more than alpha MSH alone, and also the values of edema, urban barrier leakage. So it means that what is cerebralizing hypertension here? This is a balanced combination of brain derived neurotrophic factor, glial cell derived neurotrophic factor in GDN, ciliary derived neurotrophic factor, CDNF, not growth factor, on which the Italian scientists were qualified in 1977, and also some active derived factors. So this is multimodal drug. It can produce many things like neuroregeneration, neuroplasticity, neuroprotection, and also neuromodulation. But look at these images. I think these images were not that good. You can look on these on the screen. 12-hour, 24-hour, 48-hour, and 72-hours. There is gradually more damage in only sleep deprivation cases. And as you know, that people are working whether in mountain or in desert or in any place, there are lots of nerve problems. For where are these nerve problems? Young power consumption, energy consumption, and even food and water. Okay. So they are exposed almost every day to various kinds of nerve problems. Even they are also exposed here, but I mean in one screen, so the effect could be either disappearing or long lasting, you don't know. So here you can see, if we have added copper nanoparticle, 20 to 30 nanometers in size, or silver nanoparticle, there is more damage than normal cases, you can see. And the point is that if you compare copper and silver to the same size, silver has much more damage capacity than copper. And our experimental work, and that is very, very fast. So nanoparticles aggravate the problem in situation, even depending on its constituent. Not the size, but all were 20 to 30 nanometers. Then we just tried 48 hours here, silver nanoparticles, copper nanoparticles, and you can see now we have treated with one drug called condensed. This is serotonin 3 receptor. antagonist, normal and anabolic. But we can see that after 48 hours, these are not treated. You can see there is much more neurons were alive. So the nano delivery of serotonin receptor 3 antagonist is prevented until 48 hours. So now we have alpha access given intravenously, and BDNF was also given stabilizing in combination of BDNF and BDNF and many antagonists. And you can see here. This is the NGO right, and you can see right side, left side is much more NGO. Neurons were lost because of counter. And here you can see that sleep deprivation plus in the 24 hours, many dark neurons can be seen here, and there is sponginess in the DNA here. The left side showed much more damage than the right side. Then here we have, you can see nice neurons here on this screen. Then we have given this cerebralizing alpha message by telling the alpha amino acid delivery, and sleep deprivation plus in the 24 hours. Most of the neurons in the right side are expected right now. We have tested at electron microscopy, and here we can see the right side and left side. They are quite normal as compared to the original code here. And this is one microvessel. The outside is compact, not many holes. Of course, you can't see here anything, but you can see here on the screen that alpha MSH and stabilizing treatment, more neurons were quite normal as compared to the upper level. So we can say here that sleep deprivation is a problem, and it is further exacerbated by additional traumatic injury. And if we apply not only nano delivery of one like alpha MSH, and if we combine with stabilizing, the combination has more better results in our hand for 3 hours. Stop here because there are so many other organizations who are supporting this work. This is very expensive experiments, and these are our non-clinical agencies. These are our collaborators. And I'm from Uppsala University, that is founded in 1477, one of the oldest university in Europe. Thank you very much.
Who was first? Questions? Yes.
Do you have questions?
Your questions?
No, not
hesitate. Okay. I think sleep deprivation is not a key problem only for military person.
One of the main problems.
For students, not the case.
For students too, especially.
Yes. Students during exams as well.
And your okay, questions, yes. Ladies and gentlemen.
No questions.
No questions. Thank you very much, dear.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. You are really a master.
Thank you.
Thank you.